Islam should evolve into what we call the reality's temple on earth. You don't need no Arab hand-me-down religion. You don't even need God. You don't need these things. That's good for us in our infancy, in our immaturity, when we was babies. But as we grow and mature, and even in religion itself, it says that we are the children of God. Children can't stay children forever. Children must become adults. So if we are the children of God, that means we become God. Act like God, move like God, and have the responsibility of a God.
Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Like, and some of them are sorry they are free now. Some of them know they'd rather be slaves.
Which would you rather be, Uncle Phil?
Me? Which I'd rather be? You know what I'd rather do? If I thought that I'd ever be a slave again, I'd take a gun and just end it all right away.
My ancestors. Peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of the Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. Of course, I'm the host of this particular program, known here on YouTube and on the internet in general as the Mighty, Mighty, Mighty. Angel Snub Nub 7, I am your brother, and hopefully your friend, Talik Ibn Roth. Now, yesterday, I will say this again, yesterday, to all of those who have some idea of this history of people upon this planet, yesterday, what is called interracial relationship, or some of us want to call it inter-ethnic relationship, however you want to call it, it is species mixing. However you want to call it, however, whatever you conjured up in your mind, in yesterday, nobody cared. Nobody, it was not a thought. Very rare. Nature tells us that intermixing within species is an unnatural behavior. You don't see deer, although they are deer, you do not see a deer going from one this species to the other. You have cats, but you don't see cats jumping from one species to another. In nature, you see that animals of the like stay with themselves. The only time you see something outside of this, because something out of the ordinary has happened. For the black man and woman in America, slavery for over 400 years is out of the ordinary. And what is so incredible, out of all the people you want to fall in love with, you want to fall in love with the people, the children of the people that enslaved your ancestors. How unnatural can you get? Even so, according to nature, inter-ethnic, interracial, however you want to call it, it was very rare. Now it is done because we live in an unnatural society. Unnatural behaviors. Unnatural food. Poison air. The educational system, all these influences of the mind, is confusing. So there, for me, there it is no shock that a people who went through 400 years of slavery and then Jim Crow, ostracization from main society, now we want to have a place of belonging. So we have a subconscious urge to want to be part of those who rejected us. And they rejected you in order so that they can feel supreme and show that they are better than all of humanity. And you yearn and you have a subconscious love for these who abuse and hurt you. This is a sign of great sickness. Oh, I need somebody in my life. And if they love me, let us talk about it. Let us talk about this. We want to justify our love for the children and the people that lynched my grandfathers, raped my grandmother. That tore and feathered, that would take a black woman who was pregnant, spit her womb, and the baby would come out of her womb, and then they would take their boot and smash the fetus into the soil. These are the people. Well, of course, your first thing that you will see, you have to justify. It reminds me of the abused woman. I love him. He beat you in your face. He broke your arm. And the abused woman finds some type of way to justify their sick love for the abuser. I've never seen nothing like this in my whole entire life. How can you love those that have abused and mistreated you? Well, they didn't do it. That blood runs through them, and they have done nothing to heal you. Because if you was healed, you would not want them. But you want them, and you lust for them. And you will settle for them because you are still sick. You have not been healed. This is not hate teaching. This is nature study. You don't see cats falling in love with dogs. It's very rare that you see dogs and cats getting along. And when they do, it's because it's an unnatural situation, because dogs just don't like cats. And cats don't like mice. That's just how, that's their nature. They were designed natural enemies. How are you going to love those who mistreat and abuse you? Your mind is sick. I will agree with Dr. Umar Johnson at this time that for black men or black women chasing Caucasian people, out of all the people, look at this, out of all the people on the planet, y'all got to fall in love with the slave master children. There are plenty of Chinese. There are plenty of Native Americans. There are plenty of other people on the planet, but you just got to have you a pink man. You just got to fall in love with a pink woman. Because you still a slave. You have been made unnatural. It is unnatural to love your enemy. You still got that Christian garbage in your mind. Love everybody. That's why you choose them. You don't have a Chinese woman on your arm. You're not looking for a Native American person. You're not looking for another dark person. You just got to have your Caucasian. Why is that? Because you still sick. And at this time, and I was speaking of yesterday. See, yesterday, interracial relationship, interethnic or whatever you want to call it, didn't mean nothing. Because nobody was tripping off skin color. Nobody was tripping off race. The human family was divided because of religion, because of culture, nationhood, however you want to say it. Race was not involved. But now, at this time, because this wicked poison called racism that has poison the human mind and the mind of mankind. It has caused such devastation. You have a people, and it is a Benedict Arnold. It is traitorous. And it is the worst thing that a black man or woman could do is to find love. Find solid companionship in the children of those who cause you to be in this condition. I agree with Dr. Umar Johnson, but a slave mind can't see that because they are unnatural and they just want to find love. But look where they find love. Why it's always got, I ask you the question, why it's always got to be a Caucasian person? Always. You end up. Because you're still a slave. You're still looking for satisfaction. You still want You still want that sense of belonging. You still want to be accepted by those who rejected you. I could care less about being accepted by them. They mean nothing with their filthy world, filthy lifestyle, their lies, their way of doing things is nasty and trifling. And their arrogance, their whole civilization is falling down. And it should fall down because everything that these unnatural people have built destroyed the earth. It's destroying themselves. And the black man and woman, the descendants of slaves born in America, is the primary example of a destroyed people. In the future, if we are able to destroy what is called race, it would make no difference.
Are you all right?
Get away!
Is there a heart? Is there a heart in the house? You got to have love. You got to have love in your heart tonight.
Here's a house for love. And I've learned that it don't take much to break a heart. Here's a house for love. And I've learned
a lot of your video content to me was very informative. You know, the things you talked about had substance, man. And I first really knew about you because of JT Rally One, Real Nigga News, and you and him got into a conflict with each other. And when I did my website, you were the only brother, and let me stress that, because when I did that website, blackcommune.net, and I did the video, and I asked the black YouTube community, the so-called black YouTube community, to give me your videos, because at the time, a lot of brothers were getting flagged and videos taken down. So I said, you know what, you can put your videos on my website, so that the message can still be heard for all to hear. You know, something like, you know, a little I made that website for everyone, but you were the only one that gave me permission to use your videos. And I thought that was very honorable of you and really a testament to how much you cared about the black community.
About a person's skin color or their religion or any of these factors. You could fall in love with somebody in sincerity for who they are. Right now, in the subconscious, you want to be accepted in the world by your slave master. That's where it's coming from. That's why out of all the people on the planet, you just got to have you a Caucasian person. Because that's where it is in the subconscious. It's not about love. It's about I want to be accepted by my master. That's what it's about. And you can believe it or not, your actions show the reality of it. Because that's who you choose. You're not choosing nobody else. Intermixing, that's an unnatural behavior. You see this in zoos because of incarceration. That's one of the primary reasons why men turn on men, because they can't get a woman, or a woman turn to a woman because they can't get a real man. Something has happened that it's an unnatural condition that caused this. It is unnatural for you to want somebody, regardless to whether the children did anything or not, to want the babies of those who murdered your father, who mistreated your daughters, raped your mothers. You can't see that because you're still a slave. Dr. Umar Johnson is a psychologist and he's on point. I'm not a psychologist, but I understand what has happened to us. And all these brothers and sisters on here talking all this pro-black stuff, but they want to justify sucking a white man's penis, licking a white woman, Caucasian woman's vagina. Y'all nasty things. I know you don't like what I'm saying. It's too bad. Real truth must speak to your mind, because you're a slave. See, I love black people. You really don't love black folks. You understand that black people have been mistreated and all that, but you really don't love us. Because if you love black people, then you love the black woman. And I'd rather be by myself and alone forever before I put a Caucasian woman or any woman on my arm. That's just the bottom line, because I love my people. I don't care about being alone. I came into this life and you came into this life alone. And you're not going to go into death with your Caucasian lover or anybody. You're going to leave this world by yourself. You want to have some kind of fun. Black people in this country, there's too much work to be done to gain your freedom. You want to get comfortable and have some damn fun. This is not about having fun. You have babies. You having babies just like the sheep have babies. For the benefit of who? You ain't been a damn thing. You want to have babies so they can become victims of the oppressor just like you are. I've never seen people act so crazy. But then at the same time, you think you're so dang smart. You are not smart. You're still slave. I want to ask you, do your Caucasian lover, do they fight for black liberation? What have they done for civil rights? What do they do for black people? What do they do for the black community? Your lover, your soulmate. They got to understand me. What do they do for you? They don't do anything. they take away from you, because now, since your slave master have accepted you and they love you, now you become content in your condition and you really don't give a damn about your people. I'm not trying to tell us that we should not find that special someone. See, for me, I could care less, because I'm here to fight. I'm not here to produce children, puppies, for my slave master, for the pet owner. You don't have this type of drive. You don't have this type of passion to build your own nation, to build up your community. You worried about who gonna suck your penis, who gonna lick your vagina. You sexified. You want to be careful. You don't want to offend nobody. You want to show Caucasian people, I'm not really like that. I don't hate nobody. It's not about hate. It's about standing up for yours, who you are, your people. If you don't do it, if we don't stand firm for ourselves, who gonna do it? If I did not stand firm for myself, I would not be talking to you, because nobody else gave a damn. There were those who wanted to help, but they were helpless. They didn't know what to do. You still a slave. Black power, family. Black this and black that. But you in love with the children. So since the massa couldn't get you, then the babies will. Woo! What do you get out of these? Out of this love. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad, he asked the question, why do the so-called Negro love the white man? Because they give you nothing. So we have, you fall in love. I don't want to be lonely. What's wrong with being lonely? I'd rather be lonely than in the company of a fool. I'd rather be lonely than in the company of somebody who don't understand the situation that I'm in. Only a black woman, somebody like yourself, could even begin to understand the hell that we went through and continue to go through. They have no idea. So here you go, you sit around and you want to be their teacher. Well, see, you have to understand. They don't have to understand nothing. Even if they understood, there's nothing. What is that? They don't have to go through it. Only a black woman. Only a black woman can reach and find your, who you are deep within yourself, because you are interconnected. Just like a female dog and a male dog, they are interconnected. They have the same nature. They come from the same place. These people didn't come from the same place you came from. They are the cause you are in the bad condition that you are in. Not them personally, but this place called the United States of America. This hell that their ancestors created, that they are proud of. They want us to refute Louis Farrakhan. They want us to refute Malcolm or Nat Turner. They want us to refute our people. They want us to refute the Black Panther Party. They always want us to refute somebody, because that somebody is talking about them and their evil. But when you ask them, refute George Washington, refute Thomas Jefferson, refute Patrick Henry, refute your forefathers, they can't do it. Because the forefathers, that they created had no effect on them. But it has had a very, very severe effect upon us. That's why we love our abusers. And you don't think nothing wrong with you just because you said black this and black that. You are a slave. You are Uncle Tom in the mind. You are either 100% black or you are Uncle Tom nigga. That's just the bottom line. I know you don't like what I'm saying, but that's too bad. I don't want to be by myself. You came into this world by yourself and you will leave by yourself. Again, why are you attracted to Caucasian people? Never talk about Asians. You never talk about Native Americans. You never talk about nobody. I got to find love, even if it's a Caucasian person. All these people are here. But you always gravitate toward the slave master's children. And you don't understand why. You don't see why. Because you want to be accepted by them. You're still a slave in here. And you have this hatred for your own woman. You make all kinds of excuses. You always attack this black woman, no matter what she do. And if it was not for the black woman, we wouldn't be surviving as well as we have here. Her motherly instinct kicked in. She can't help that. But now this is 2012 and we know so much. Or we think we know so much. And we want to blame the black woman for saving our lives. Now we want to control the force that caused us to live. With no wisdom. We just want to control something. You must earn your respect. You must earn the right to be a leader. Not because you have a penis. You must be able to lead by your intelligence. You must create success. People don't follow losers, they follow winners. Show this woman that you are a winner. Build something with your hands. I see the videos. I see the pretty speeches and the pretty writing. Build something with your hands to support what you're talking about. And I guarantee you, your black woman will stand with you because she's always been with you. But y'all niggas got to tripping. And you want something for nothing. Those days are over. So to take you out of your misery, you run and you seek a Caucasian person because they're not going to bother you. They're not going to ask them. They're not going to ask your lazy ass to stop playing Nintendo. Stop talking about black power and build something. That's why you run to somebody else. Because you don't have to do nothing. Oh, man. Thank you for listening. I know many of you are angry, and that's how we're supposed to be. But think about it. It's better to accept the truth than continue to live in these delusions that we created for ourselves, because if you think that you're still not a slave and still don't have a slave mentality, you are greatly mistaken. That's why you act and do what you do. Jot down your comments. This is your brother, Talib Kimura. This was and is the Reality's Temple on Earth. In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of the Reality's Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I'm the host, known here as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snub Nub 7. I am your brother and hopefully your friend, Talik Ibn Ra. It is very sad But I have never been surrounded or in the presence in all my almost half of a century of living. The so-called black man.
Yes. I want that. Ooh, I need that. Got to have that. It's
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ebenrod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign. In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always. Century of living. The so-called black man of America, these new black men that I interact with and I am surrounded by, I've never heard a group of black men who are a bunch of wimps. These are the most wimpiest, the most cowardly, the most sissified, the most tacky group of black men I've ever known. I never, as a child, I never heard such things. As a teenager, I never heard such things. But now, in 2012, these so-called black men, they sound so pathetic, they sound so pitiful. And they were weak when I was a child. And now the black man has become even weaker in 2012. You hear these poor, pathetic persons. And most of them come on YouTube and they hide their face. And I understand why you hide your face, because you are ashamed of yourself. I can show my face because I am not ashamed of myself. No matter what I am proud of that, and I will show you that. And I fear no man, no God, no nothing. Period. You don't like who and what I am? To hell with you. But y'all supposed to be men. You wimpified, sissified. I've never been around such cowardly, pathetic trolls, because that's what they are, a bunch of trolls crying on YouTube. Crying about what? Crying about black women. Who cares? The black women stopping them from being successful. The black women should support them to do this and that. You are a man. You don't need nobody to help you do a damn thing. Just do it. They tell me that the black woman is the greatest helper to the racist Caucasian or pink male. If it wasn't for the black woman helping the racist people, they could do better, because we need your help. You ain't doing nothing to get that need, that is in need of assistance, that needs somebody's help. What are you doing? What school are you building? What land are you buying? What are you doing, Negro? You ain't doing nothing. Then you want to try to talk about black women is the greatest helper of the racist Caucasian people. What are you? When you reach in your pocket, whose money are you spending? When you pull that dollar bill out, whose face is on it? The racist Caucasian people faces on it. Who gives that dollar bill value? You don't. Only thing you do is spend it. Whose language do you speak, Negro? The car you driving, who built that car? Who gave you your job? Who is the Negro out on the street killing other black men in the street? Living off of women. Selling drugs to our people. Don't pay and take care of your babies. You are a drunk and a pedophile. Woman bashers, woman beaters. And you doing all these different things, but the black woman is the greatest helper to the racist Caucasian pink people. Get out of here with the dude. Woo, y'all. Oh man, these people are so tacky to me. Everything that you are about, everything that you do, it comes from pink people. So the only thing black women have done within recent times is sidestep you and go straight and directly to the pink people themselves, and they get what they want. But in your mind, you're delusional, because you was told, as long as you have a job, get your little education and whatever, these black women supposed to flock to you. Women, whether they are black women or Caucasian women, Chinese, they don't flock to weak-ass people. Y'all weak. What do you have to offer? There's nothing that you can give this black woman that she can't get herself. And you blame black women for your problems. Blame women for the fact that you are nothing. Trifling and a nobody. Whose fault is that? That's our fault as men. That's not their fault. You're the one that claim to be the provider. You are the one that claim to be the protector. You ain't providing a damn thing, and you damn sure ain't protecting nobody. Anybody at any time can come into the so-called black community. It's so-called black community because there is no commune among those who live there. There is no unification among those who live there. There is no sense of community among those. So anybody, any male, anybody from anywhere can come into the black community and do whatever they want to black women and children and you too. And it's all the black women's fault. But you the provider and you the protector, you ain't protecting a damn thing. You want the honor, you want the respect, but you ain't earned it. The only thing you have is a penis. And I question whether you have that or not. Oh, the black woman don't want me. First of all, as a male, just because you have a job, just because you looking good and looking sharp, that don't mean women's supposed to be running after you. In nature, it's the male that always chase the woman. And since we know that she's attracted to this racist beast, then we're going to have to go all out of our way to try to get her back. Y'all don't know how to romance nobody. You don't know how to be suave. You don't have no swag. You don't know how to romance that woman and chase her. She's supposed to chase you because you got it going on and you don't. And that's why the so-called thug Negroes, they know how to romance. They know how to say beautiful things. They know how to get that woman. They know how to be the chaser. Because they know once they get her, she's got. You just want to sit back and complain. You're supposed to sit back in your house. And as long as you got a job and education and a car, you think they supposed to just, oh, wow, he's great. I want him. That ain't how it works. Especially when you are in competition with other men, and the greatest competition is against that racist Caucasian pink man and the world that he's built, because she thrives and she survives off what that pink man has given her. And in her mind, she's Europeanized just like you are. You are Europeanized and a slave just like she is. And a slave woman always want to try to get closer to Massa, because she feels that makes her life better. Why should she romance another slave that can't do nothing for her? So if you romance her and you chase that woman and that don't work, she don't want you, so the hell what? Then why don't you concentrate on what you should be doing anyway, is building a nation for yourself. Why are you in America helping the Caucasian man put value on his dollar? Why you are helping another man build his world? That make you a bitch. That make you a gal. That make you, and that's why most of you are the way you are, because you have no masculinity. That's why you a whimper. That's why you cry. Because you have not reached out. You don't know how to embrace your masculine side. You think because you holler and you scream, or maybe you can fight a little bit, have a little money in your pocket, you think that makes you a man. But it don't. What makes you a man is the ability to create and become independent and do your own thing, just like all the men around the earth. The Chinese are doing that thing. The Indians are doing that thing. The Native Americans, people around the earth, they're doing. These men are trying to do their thing. Everybody, all the males are trying to do their thing so they can attract and have their women, except you. So since you can't protect and can't build nothing, you want a woman, but you don't have no damn house to put her in. You don't have no school for her children to go to, so those children can learn what you want them to learn. So those boys can grow up to be what you want them to be. Be a man. Build something. Stop being a wimp looking for somebody to blame because you pathetic. Become a nation builder. And when you become a nation builder, you will create money that you put value on. So that you can pull out of your pocket a dollar bill with your face on it and compare it to the face of the racist Caucasian man, and you can look at that man and say, look, my dollar has more value than yours. And that is possible if you try. But the only thing on your mind, I want a woman so you can screw y'all sexify. Instead of having sex with the universe, having sex with yourself in order to encourage yourself to get that orgasm, make you feel good about nation building. Do you understand? If you felt like towards nation building like you do towards your damn orgasm, you'd be right there. You'd be on point. I wouldn't have nothing to say. I wouldn't have nothing to say because I could look at what your hands have built. I see your school. I see your farmland. I see your nation. I will see your civilization coming up. But right now, the only thing we see is a bunch of wimps, and the women see that too. And I don't blame them. I don't blame them for not wanting us. We need to get our act together. Stand up and be a man. Thank you for listening. Let's talk about it. In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. Of course, I'm the host of this particular program, known here on YouTube and the internet in general as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snubnub 7. I am your brother and hopefully your friend. Today, I am the Black Dragon. Yeah. I would like to first send a shout out to my student and minister, Andre Edmond 69. And with that said, I was reminded of a story that was told to me by a police officer. And the police officer said that one of the worst type of calls that he would have to answer are the calls of or in relation to domestic violence. So one day he received one of these calls, and the caller, by the sound of the voice, was in great desperation. And when he arrived on the scene, the person that made the call, their clothes was ripped and they had punch marks in the face and they suffered great injury. And other police officers arrived on the scene, and the perpetrator of these injuries, the abuser, was still in the house. So the police officers went into the residence to arrest the one that was accused of by the victim who called the police.
then you're just dumb.
All right, all right. Shout out to Reality's Temple in the building. Well, just from us, I got to get him on here, man. You talk about somebody polarizing. Whoa. that brother is, I'll leave that alone. Shout out to the brother, though, Just.
We sell soul food. As a matter of fact, we've been told that Old Henry's is one of the few soul food restaurants in the city of St. Louis, in the state, and in the Midwest. We plan to start our food truck next month.
Okay.
Want that food truck to go all over.
All righty then.
So, and we get the exposure, and we're already taking orders for events. Just took an order for July 31st. We took an order for July 29th. There's a guy who has a construction company. He owns quite a few of them, and we're going to be going to their sites and serving food, serving lunch. And we got a lot of interesting stuff going on.
All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. I'm Angel Snow No 7. This is my friend
Ada Taylor.
This is Old Henry Restaurant. If you're ever in the St. Louis area, come check them out. We had a good time just celebrating my sister's birthday, and everything was A-O-T.
All right. All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Just keep it going.
What about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping storm?
The earth, who gives a damn? We are here. Learn how to live, learn how to love other human beings. Learn how to have appreciation and respect for the earth, animal life, and the grass and the trees.
And that is Brother Talik from the Reality Temples on Earth channel. And if you get a chance to subscribe, please do subscribe to his channel. He's a good brother. You know, he's doing good work, and he wants to do good constructive things. He has good information to provide. So please do check out his channel if you get a chance.
I keep it real.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I trust that feeling. Does anybody have any questions of me before I get out of here? Let's see what you guys are saying. What's up, Soul Sister Rona? Hey, Talik. I'm the brother that did my Mike Jackson in Tunica, Mississippi. Hey, now. Hello to Terry. Respect. Bless up. Bless up. Bless up.
In the first place, as the police attempted to arrest the person, this male that was suspected of beating this female, this particular woman, who she called the police. As they placed the handcuffs on the guy, and was getting ready to lead him to the police officer to take him to jail, the victim got angry and upset. Leave him alone. I changed my mind. Here's a person bleeding from the head, clothes all ripped up. You could tell they were beaten, but the victim was telling the police officers, whom they call, leave this guy alone. But of course, the police had to make an arrest because of the situation. So the victim jumped on the back of the police officers, tugging at the police officers, going to the point, almost causing the police officers injury, protecting the person that beat them. Mind-boggling, ain't it? But this is an everyday occurrence. You have women, and you have some people in general, especially those who are the descendants of slaves born in America. We have an extreme sickness. We fall in love with those who abuse us, those who make mockery of us, those who mistreat us. I heard a sister say, and was talking about this mental illness, was called Stockholm Syndrome. Whatever it is, it's a reality. Why would a woman protect a woman beater, a woman basher? You have on YouTube so-called brothers, black men, that dedicate their channels to woman bashing, making mockery, beating up on females because they have nothing else to do. Because real men don't spend their time bashing women. Real men spend their time banging on the beast that caused the condition that both black men and women face in 2012. That's what real men do. But these punks, these sissified trolls hide their face. And because they upset because these women don't want you, I wouldn't want you either if I was a female. But just like the abused woman, black people have a love for those who mistreat us. If I began to talk about Caucasian people, you will see so many black folks get all angry or upset, want to jump on my back and beat me up. To protect those who have beat us up for 400 years. That is a sickness. They actually get angry. Why would a woman want to protect a woman basher? A woman beater? A male gendered person that says that the woman is nothing but a rib. You ain't a full person. But you're not like me. I came from God, but God made me whole, and you nothing but my rib. In religious teaching, the female prophets, there are female prophets, but you don't hear too much about them. Because female prophets, what they had to bring to the table don't mean a dang thing. These men look at you as a breeding machine. They just want you to shake your booty, shake your breasts. They don't see nothing really divine about you. You're just an object to help them rule something. You're just a vessel so they can live. That's all. You are to them. You as a woman are not seen as a full human being. Thus, you are in a male-dominated patriarchal society. You are denied opportunity like black folks in general have been denied proper opportunity within this racist system this country called the United Snakes of America. And it seems the more they abuse you, the more they make mockery of you, the more you are exploited, the more you love these people. Oh, wow. What kind of Jesus, what kind of Muhammad want that for you? Jesus and Muhammad make you less than a man? Your word don't mean nothing. But without you, these corny ass things that call themselves men would not even exist. They have no respect for you and the womb. Just like these racist Caucasian people in America don't respect black folks, but for over 300 years of free slave labor, that's what built this nation. 100 years of underpaid labor, that's what built this country. Without the man, without the woman, the man ain't nothing. Without the black people, this country wouldn't be nothing. Oh. But see, religion enters. And see, religion tells us to turn the other cheek. Love your enemy. And the religion teaches y'all women to obey the man. Who wrote this religion? Who gave you these gods? Was it another woman? Or was it a man? It's all about man. Your God is called a he. Your God is never called a she. You tell me why God can't be a she. Why God can't never be considered a he. I mean a she. And why God had to send his only begotten son. How come God couldn't send a daughter to get the job done? God, why is God called a he when God has no use of gender? You need a he and a she in order to reproduce. God don't need, God is self-replicating, does not need a female. So why is God called a he? You embrace these teachings, you embrace these things that degrade you, that deny you your greatest potential. We as a people, the black man and woman in America, we deny ourselves so we can make other people happy. You deny yourself so you can make your man happy. Cook his food, wash his stinking underwear. Be a slave. And that's the problem with us black folks in America. We still have a slave mentality. Be quiet. Don't look out for yourself. We got to make sure our master is comfortable. It is better to be rotten and dead in the grave than live this way. You and I, we all have lives. Ain't nobody life better than ours. You should not want to serve nobody. After 400 years of slavery as a people, and even longer exploitation as womanhood, you should be ready to break the shackles of slavery and exploitation. You need to be around men that want to raise you up for real so that you can develop into your fullest potential rather than these guys being a servant to them. Waiting on them to give you opportunity when you was born with opportunity. You came from the same place, the same space, the same dark womb of the universe as they did. What makes them so special? You have to bow down and listen to everything they say like they are God. Let us stop allowing people, these bums, to be God. White folks ain't God. And these men ain't God either. Thank you for listening. Jot down your comments.
In the name of my ancestors. Peace, forever and always, and welcome to another edition of the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. Of course, I'm the host of this particular program, known here on YouTube and in various places on the internet as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snub Nub 7. I am your brother and hopefully your friend, Talik Ibn Ra. I would like to, and I hope that somebody, somewhere at some time, could bring to me a better understanding of what some of you black males call black feminism. And the control of over 40 years that the black woman has had that brought down the black community for 40 years. How it is so detrimental to the community, and blase, blase. I really want, seriously, for somebody to give me an understanding of this phenomenon. Now, this is my conclusion. If you claim to be a strong black man, if you claim to be that you are some leader, yes, black feminism, that type of mentality, yes, it's detrimental to the struggle and the development of our community and a hindrance to we as a people to inevitably, excuse me, my pronunciation is a little bit off, but we wish to create a nation one day in the future. There is no doubt about that. However, for me, black feminism, if I'm a strong black man, black feminism should not stop you from doing anything. If you're a strong black man, I don't care if not one black female wants to be on your side and walk with you, then you walk alone. What, are you scared to walk by yourself? You need your mama there to hold your hand and take you across the street. And then when you fall down and scrape your little knee, you need some woman to grab your knee and kiss your knee and tell you everything gonna be all right. Somebody told me, or I heard somebody say, oh, the black man, so much pressure is on the black man. People don't understand. So what? You have the pressure. Deal with it. What you crying for? You don't need no woman to validate your manhood. So you're going to try to beat the woman up. You're going to bash the woman and try to make her accept you for who you are. Because see,
persuaded by the truth, but take a look at what's going on. next week on these same stations. And you can bet the last money, it's all going to be a stone gas, honey. I'm Don Cornelius, and as always, in parting, we wish you love. Peace.